welcome back to this week's edition of After the Bell. I'm your host, a fan advocate, Terry Boddie. And as you can see, I've been joined by Miss Josette Bynum and the family. Miss Bynum, we are a month into your reign as talent arbitrator and total control over OVW. During that time, you have used every means and trick in the book to control everything that goes on, even to the point where our first interview was lost in a computer. So thank you for gracing us with the second interview, man. But my point is that you, being the professional that you are, know that the fans control really what goes on here with their pocketbooks and wallets. And the fans have expressed through social media that they are not pleased at all. They are very upset and disappointed with what they're seeing out of you here at OVW. Is there anything that you would like to share with the fans to reassure them?
I'm sorry, Terry. Where do you see that the fans are disappointed? Because in the last month of my reign, I have done nothing but put butts in the seats, bringing money into OVW. The fans were so upset, they would not come to watch. They have a choice. With their pocketbooks, they can keep it in their pockets. But they choose to drive their old trucks and bicycles up to 4,400 miles of the road and spend their money to watch me and the family. I think they made a decision.
They very well may have. But speaking of driving themselves to the Davis Arena, we're on the verge of the Saturday Night Special, where the family plays a very vital role in what goes on. And with your permission, I'd like to ask these gentlemen their opinions about their matches and their contests.
Go ahead and ask them. Go ahead and ask them. Go ahead.
First off, Rob Terry, you are on the verge of becoming the sixth man to join the Triple Crown Club here at Ohio Valley Wrestling, joining your family mate, Rudy Switchblade, but in doing so, in probably record time. Do you think that this Saturday will be a historic night for you?
I don't think, I know it's going to be a historic night for the family of Will Stone. Do you understand it?
Yes, sir. Next, I'd like to address the OVW Southern Tag Team Champions. We have Mr. Pentacular, Jesse Gobbers. Sir, you've been on TMZ, national television shows, featured in big-time wrestling magazines, and it's easiest to say that you are the most narcissistic member of the Ohio Valley Wrestling staff. And Larry Switchblade, you are a Triple Crown winner, multiple-time champion, have wrestled all over the world. You two combined, as you call yourselves now, the best team ever, are facing a team that is joining us literally on a whim in a team of the newest TNA Impact star, Alex Silva, and former tag team and television title holder, Shiloh Jones. Gentlemen, are you concerned at all about what these gentlemen are going to do to you in taking your titles?
You know, first, I find it funny that Alex Silva likes to call himself the lone wolf, yet he decides to go after the tag team titles. It makes no sense. It's probably the biggest mistake he's ever going to make. What he should have done was stick to singles competition, because like you said, we are the best team ever.
That was what you told me to say.
You need not smart back after we give you an opportunity to talk. Do you understand? Get out of it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. That's why we're in this in the first place. So when we do this, the Saturday Night Special where you think Shiloh Jones and the Lone Wolf are just going to miraculously add the synergy of two of the best talents that OVW has to offer, you're sadly mistaken. You, sir, don't have to hate me because you ain't me.
Well, I definitely don't hate you, sir. But
if I may now address the six-time television champion, Muhammad Ali Baez. Sir, you have wrestled in your career. You have taken on Hall of Famers. You defeated legends. You schooled many a rookie who want to try to make a name for themselves here in Ohio Valley Wrestling.
One time I beat Mark Terry, too. Okay, that one.
Well, even so, potential Triple Crown winners. My question to you, sir, is simply this. Why are you avoiding Jaden Olivencia?
Whoa. The fan advocate. Obviously, you're not an advocate for me. Listen, Terry, and listen real good. A very courageous and wise man named George W. Bush once said, "We do not negotiate with terrorists." Jaden Olivencia attacks me when I'm not looking. Jaden Olivencia attacks me from behind. He is terrorizing me. He's not a fair competitor. And I will not negotiate with a terrorist. I will not negotiate with a bully. So, no. I'll defend this title against anybody on this roster besides Jaden Olivencia. Thank you.
You calling somebody a bully and saying somebody's not playing fair? Okay. Ms. Bynum, my last question is simply to you. Again, we know what you've been doing here at Ohio Valley Wrestling. Absolutely. But I've been watching the product for a long time, and so have the fans. And they know personally that you have benefited professionally and personally from what Ohio Valley Wrestling has given you the opportunity to do. What Danny Davis has given you the opportunity to do. Do you now feel any remorse about what you've done to the company that he started, to the company that gave you an opportunity?
It is innovative, it is fresh, it is so damn talented that it's a shame that it's standing in this ring right now. The old OVW was boring, it was bland, it was stupid, it was so loaded with sugar and cream, it was not fit for consumption. I did Danny Davis a favor by sending him home. You, all of these men, myself, the fans, have all benefited since I took over OVW. You're welcome.
Well, fans, with that, we're going to call it a show. Thanks again for tuning in to After the Bell. I'm the fan advocate, Terry Boddie, and I'll see you at the shows.